You want to know more about search volume on YouTube, right? Well, there are many different keyword tools that give you search volume for a YouTube keyword. But so many choices, which of these should you use? Let's have a closer look. There are these tools that give you an estimate using public YouTube statistics. They give you a great rule of thumb to work with, but keep in mind that they do not have actual search volume data. Then there are these tools that use Google search volume data. They are great because they have real search volume data, but keep in mind that Google is not the same as YouTube. Search behavior is different on both search engines. For example, if people want to find out more about a car, then watching a video on YouTube makes more sense. And if they actually want to buy the car, then searching for a dealership on Google makes more sense. Two search engines for different purposes, really. Okay, then we have one single tool that actually has real search volume for YouTube. Google Trends. Seriously, that is the only tool that has search volume data for YouTube. YouTube does not share this data with anyone else. However, Google Trends does not show you precise search volume numbers. 100 just means that it is the highest search volume seen for this search term. Only if you compare two search terms, then you can see which one has more search volume. So it is not perfect for our SEO purposes, but I'm glad that we have it. And finally, there are the search bar suggestions. These are something special, and I will talk about them in a minute since they are really useful. But back to the question, which tool should you use to determine the search volume? Okay, you start your research with a search term, a keyword. Now you want to know how much search volume it has, right? Step 1 is to use the search bar suggestions to find out if the search term is commonly used. You may find out that it is not. Then you have to look for a different search term. No use to optimize your video for a search term that no one is searching, right? But if the search bar suggestions tell you that it is indeed a commonly used search term, then go ahead. But before I explain you how to use the search bar suggestions, let me complete these steps. So the next step would be to look at Google Trends. Although this tool has trends in its name, for our purposes it is useful to see if the search volume has an all-time high. Like here for example, this would be an evergreen topic. People are searching for how to tie a tie all the time. Truly evergreen. By the way, make sure to select YouTube search here to look at YouTube search volume. So if you are not sure if your search term is searched all the time, then use Google Trends to verify that. And depending on what it says, you may look for a different search term or go for it. But if you already know that it is the case, then you may just skip Google Trends and proceed. Next up is using one of the additional tools to make your final decision. So at this point, you have multiple search terms that you consider targeting, consider optimizing your video for. But which search term should you choose? Well, here is where the other tools become useful. But big question, which type of tool should you use? The ones which estimate search volume on YouTube or the ones that give you actual search volume on Google? Well, it depends on your niche. Do you believe that the search behavior for your niche is the same on YouTube and Google? If yes, use one of these tools. If no, or when in doubt, use one of those tools. Sorry, my friend, it's a mess, right? So many different tools. But you know, that's how it is. I also wish there was one tool that has actual search volume for YouTube. But since there is none, we have to work with what we got. And you may wonder why I added the search bar suggestions in step 1. After all, we could just always skip Google Trends and choose one tool in step 3 and use only this one. Well, I'm sorry to say that, but all the tools have their flaws. They can fail us. So we need the combination of the tools to get a dependable search volume for our search term. And for that reason, I'm helping you with all the 3 steps with Morningfame. It uses the search bar suggestions, Google Trends, and a YouTube estimate. It's not that complicated in the end. Let me show you. Here in the Morningfame keyword research tool, you enter a search term. Step 1, check this symbol. It has a red cross, so that's a no-go at step 1. Let's try another search term. Green check. Excellent. That's a commonly used search term. On to step 2. Let's quickly check if this one is an evergreen. On Morningfame, just click this Google Trends button here. And yes, looks good. Let's go ahead with this search term. As I said, step 3 is all about comparing a bunch of search terms that all have passed steps 1 and 2. So you see Morningfame's search volume estimate here. And now we can compare two search terms and their search volume by clicking the Compare With button. Here you go. This one has a higher search volume. By the way, you can double check your decision by clicking the Google Trends button here. Nice, right? Here you can see as well that the blue search term has a higher search volume. Okay, that's the three steps to find search volume on YouTube. But wait a moment, what is it about the search bar suggestions? Morningfame uses them automatically for you and shows the green check or the red cross. But how does this work actually? Let me show you. The green check means that the search term has a minimum amount of search traffic. So that's good to know, because if you get a red cross, then it is likely that people are not searching for it. This is critical to know, because you wouldn't want to optimize your video for a search term that no one is using, right? Behind the scenes, Morningfame is using the search bar suggestions, and you can actually do it yourself easily. It's convenient to have Morningfame do it for you, but now I wanna show you how you can do it yourself. Let's go over to YouTube. And let's say we have the search term how to tie a tie. We already know that this is a commonly used search term, but look closely. When I start entering the search term into the search bar, then how to tie space, see that? It already suggested how to tie a tie because it is predicting that you want to enter the search term. Predicting. That's the important word. The search bar suggestions are predicting what you want to enter. Very likely you want to enter how to tie a tie here. A little less likely, but still very likely, you may want to search for how to tie a bow tie. But how does YouTube know that? How can it predict what you want to search? Quite simple actually. It looks at what people searched in the past. It looks at the actual search volume. YouTube has the search volume, of course. It's not sharing the search volume with us, but through the lens of these suggestions, we get a peek of what people commonly search for. You know, internally, YouTube knows all the search terms that begin with how to tie, and it has their search volume numbers. Then it chooses the ones with the highest volumes and shows them in the suggestions. Let's try another search term, grow a YouTube channel. But wait, I don't enter the full search term. I enter everything except the last word. So, grow a YouTube space. And here we go. Grow a YouTube channel is shown in the suggestions. That means it is a commonly used search term. Green check. Morningfame does the same thing. It enters the search term except the last word. And if the full search term shows up in the suggestions, then it shows a green check. Otherwise, it shows a red cross. But why should we not enter the full search term? Well, I said in the beginning that the search bar predicts what you want to enter. Look, it even says search predictions here. And that prediction only happens when you enter just part of the search term. If you already entered the full search term, then there is nothing to predict anymore, right? And we want to make use of that prediction. It is super important. Let me explain why. Here we have a slightly different search term, growing a YouTube channel 2018. We enter the full search term and get these suggestions. The problem is now that YouTube looks at all search terms that begin with growing a YouTube channel 2018, and it only has these 5 search terms. So it shows them in the suggestions even though they may have very, very low search volume, because there are just no other search terms that are similar. But look at what happens when we enter the search term except the last word, without 2018. Look at that. Growing a YouTube channel 2018 does not show up. We have in 2018, but not with only 2018. Since we only entered growing a YouTube channel, well, YouTube has many more search terms to choose from now, and it suggests those that have the highest search volume. Our original search term, growing a YouTube channel 2018, just doesn't make it. The other search terms are more commonly used, have higher search volume, and that is why we must not enter the full search term. This way, we cleverly use the prediction of the search bar suggestions to get a peek into the search volume it has under the hood. So when you enter a search term, then enter it slowly. For example, let's check if search bar suggestions is a commonly used search term. We enter search space, it doesn't show up. Now bar space, still doesn't show up. Okay, very slowly. S, nope, doesn't show up. Now U, bingo, it now shows up. But is it a commonly used search term? This is actually a gray area. We already entered most of the search term and YouTube has only 3 suggestions at this point. So it is not very commonly used. Otherwise, it would show up earlier when we entered less of the search term. But since we didn't enter the full search term, it was predicted. A prediction took place to a certain extent. So people do search this search term, but not that many. Okay, in this special case, use your human intuition to say if it is commonly used or not. In this particular case, I decided that it is not commonly used and that I do not optimize this video, the one you are watching right now, for this search term. I mean, this search term would be a good fit for this video, right? But I chose to go for how to find search volume on YouTube instead. This search term already shows up when I enter just how to find search V. Here it is very clear that we have a commonly used search term. And of course, Morningfame shows a green check for it. Alright, I hope this helps. But keep in mind one important thing. Make sure that you only consider search terms that have low enough competition. If you have a search term with high search volume, but at the same time it is too competitive for your channel, then your video won't rank and you don't get any of that search traffic. So step 0 is to find a search term that is not too competitive. If you want to learn more about how you can find those low competition search terms, then check out this playlist. It contains all the tips that I have that are particularly useful for small channels, because small channels cannot beat a lot of competition yet. Cheers, my friends!